You alright, man? Yeah, you gotta try to go around that corner slower.
Because it's pretty extreme sport, eh? And I didn't know anyone else who did it.
Oh, he's ripping out.
I thought it was pretty cool.
When you're flying down that hill, your nature becomes part of you, and you're an animal again.
Well, you know, it's really, it's orgasmic, really. It's much better than anything you've ever seen before.
Oh, shit!
Woks were developed in feudal China during the Wang Dynasty. Despite being its inventors, the Chinese never fully realized the wok's extreme potential. The first accounts of a wok being ridden came from China's neighbor, Japan. Woking faded into obscurity until the mid-1960s, when popular culture revived it as an everyman's pastime. The psychedelic woking culture flourished during the Summer of Love, until the growing number of woking-related casualties caused it to be banned in 1972. Still illegal, woking went underground for the next 2.5 decades, until an international woking revival movement emerged. At the forefront of this resurrection were the Daggers, a small crew from the backwater English colony, New Zealand.
Well, firstly, there's Skip and Brown. They have quite an aggressive style, you know. It's all about tricks and, you know, speed and that sort of thing. While for Blunt, it's more, you know, it's more of a naturalistic approach. It has to flow, so to speak. He can't just go down and, you know, that's that. He has to get it, you know, balanced. And there was Klaus, who he didn't have a style per se. It was sort of constantly under development. It never reached its full form, so to speak.
We're going on a national tour soon, and that's going to be epic. We're going to...
Fuck, I'm excited, are you guys?
We're going to walk the crap out of the country.
Don't, I'm getting very stoned from there.
Should be good.
You know, I was gonna blow New Zealand's mind, pretty much. I was gonna have a good time. You know, I was pretty much just gonna prove that I'm so much better than Klaus.
Oh, that's exciting. That's really exciting.
I thought it was gonna be a real cool way, because I, you know, I've never been out of Auckland, going to see the country and other stuff like that.
But, yeah. When we first went into print in 2001, that was actually the first time the Daggers got any significant media coverage. They, before then, they were sort of, you know, like a rumour, they were a whisper on the wind, so to speak. Woking Life is the only real woking magazine. You know, it's the one that actually gets out there, you know. It shows woking for what it really is, and what it can be, and what it was, and, you know. Our most popular issue, was rather scandalous. It had Lindsay Lohan walking topless at Piha. We were sued for that. They said it was slander and malicious and fake, that sort of jazz. However, it remains to be our best selling issue. We're still taking back orders. It's,
First day of the national tour. Hyped. It's gonna be great. We're gonna walk pretty hard. We'll be right back.
It was the biggest, hardest day of walking. We went out to all the best Auckland sites, out in the Waitakes, all the cones, One Tree Hill, all that crap. And then we're back at base, and we're just, you know, over a couple of beers talking about it, and Klaus said he's gonna walk the unwalkable hill, and we told him not to, but he was determined, and it was unwalkable.
Klaus said he was going to walk some mean hillway, and that wouldn't go too well.
So I just thought at first it was just a normal bail, and
we didn't know if it was for real or not, you know, because we were still, like, it was like the shock sort of, and that went on for a couple of days. We sort of thought he was still hanging around, especially Blunt. You know, just crazy shit.
Oh, you know, it was a bit sad. You know, some of the team were a bit down, but you know, we all got over it. I mean, we're over it now. We just had to move on with our walking, move on with our lives.
I just died in your arms tonight. It must have been something you said. I just died in your arms tonight.